still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
Lincoln, pick up the keys.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like we asked. Put the grease as part of it to make it look good. If you got doubts, why take the chance? We should get going. You got the keys so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses. Ah, that poor fuck back there. He ain't got no idea what he's in for.
What was his cut? 5%?
They're about, but not like he'll be able to spend it. Feds will be watching his every move for the rest of his life. Probably be better we just whacked him.
If I learned anything in Nam, always a good idea to dangle someone out there. Use him to get everybody's attention, and you just slip away.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Old Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? Are you going to answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting them onto a medical ship. Woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand and a leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says then? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you ask.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God, watch out! Like I was saying. Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. Conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig. Guys at the Missouri probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat. Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Back it up to the loading dock.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigger before.
I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
You The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Now, here we go.
Put your IDs up to the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
What the fuck's this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
I'll have Miss Gale call up your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
Need to check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. You just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job, but any old nigga who staggers in is hired on the spot. You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you!
Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are. Put those bags on the table there.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
It gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use...
God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second. Right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
We've been renting out. Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they needed to be out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's John. Stop.
Huh?
Lincoln, get over here, man.
Oh, I hope this combination skeletal goddess is legit. Well, I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
Holy fucking shit.
There he is, taking cover.
Walk out of here is if we get the weapons stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Fuck! Come on, open!
Give me that damn thing. Face way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
Got an officer down! Boy, you are shit out of luck!
Well, Sammy had men all over the place. One of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniform.
Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
Hey, man, be careful.
Anyway, as I was saying,
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets. You remember Marty and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say, sure. Free money as far as I'm.
Damn, you're scratching the paint.
Anyhow, like I was saying, I say sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned.
Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into Harrow and that they're looking for an apartment down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about.
I ain't said more than three words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, heroin was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he'd keep his old man from fighting out. We'll still clear the Hollow in Frisco, just selling the French wall. George's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man.
Come on, we're going through the front. I ain't having your wall here. I ask you to back door.
Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.